Hello and welcome. There are many word plays within the English language. These word plays work on various levels. Use of letter form is one of these. Indeed, books have been written on the esoteric qualities of the alphabet, and things perhaps go much deeper. Ilios is the name of the Greek mythological sun god. One of the oldest known cities in Egypt is called the city of the sun, Heliopolis, also referred to as On. When Helios appears on the Horai zone, perhaps one might greet Helios by saying hello. After all, the hero sun has just emerged after battle with Set, the god of the underworld. Hello, Helios. Now, I realise the etymology of these words officially doesn't exactly line up, but in the context of a sun god coming above the horizon in the morning, one might expect one to say hello to this entity. So I just find it interesting, and I'll leave it at that. Once arisen, the light of the sun now shines upon the city of On, and on all that one can see. For simplicity, both hello and on could be thought of as positive words, as opposed to goodbye and off. Goodbye perhaps refers to God-bye. Anyway. Interestingly, if we reverse the O and N of on, we get no. A negative word, shall we say. Many people will be familiar with the Christogram IHS, which refers to the holy name of Jesus. From the Christogram Wikipedia page, we can read, the Greek letter iota is represented by the I and the eta by H, whilst the Greek letter sigma is either in its lunate form, represented by the C, or in its final form, represented by the S. Because the Latin alphabet letters I and J were not systematically distinguished until the 17th century, JHS and JHC were equivalent to IHS and IHC. The H in Greek is commonly pronounced as an E sound, held longer.
Ita. Ita.
So quite simply, IHS can be pronounced yes. Yes. It seems that among many other names for the sun is called yes. So the Jess in Jesus is perhaps yes. And we all know that Jesus is the sun, and Jesus gets worshipped on Sunday. Yes is an inclusive part of the Optus logo. Optus is a communications company headquartered in Sydney, Australia. On this Optus calling card, we can see the yes above Australia. Occultists love wordplay. Now, if the Jess is yes, and we say Jesus or Yesus, what about Optus? Opt is the Greek root for eye, as in optical. Optus, Jesus, or Yesus. Without eyes, we can't see the light. And without light, we can't see with our eyes.
Oh, yes! Oh, God, yes! Oh, yes! Oh, God, yes!
Yes! Yes! Oh, my God, yes!
Sounds corny and seedy.
Oh, God, yeah!
Oh, yes! Oh, my God.
Oh, my God!
Oh, my God!
Oh, yes! Oh, my God!
Oh, yes! Oh, God, yes!
So good. So good.
Yes! Yes! Oh, yes! Yes. Oh, my God! Oh!
Sounds corny and seedy, but yes, indeedy. Give me the simple life. Give me the simple life. Give me the simple
my god, yes! It sounds corny and seedy, but yes indeedy, I'll give you my simple perspective on life and things. You know what I mean, my humble opinion, that can change from time to time. First, I'll reiterate some basics. A person's religious belief largely depends upon their parents' belief and one's geographical place of birth. The Christian will understandably find the notions set forth in this video as sheer lunacy. Please keep in mind, it is not my intention to state that anything is a fact. That is always up to you to work out. Santos Bonacci brought the IHS-IES yes connection to my attention. Bonacci also remarks that we nod our heads up and down for the affirmative yes, and he remarks that in doing this our eyes track the sun. Interestingly, when we say no, our heads go from side to side. Both of these movements combined form a cross shape. With symbolism, there are layers upon layers of meaning. And this might be one of those layers. How do we use words such as yes, no, Jesus Christ, God, good and evil, etc.? Just think about it. These words, we interchange them in our language. It's interesting. Anyway, when I mention any researcher, I do not necessarily agree with all of their teachings. Jordan Maxwell brought the notion of the connection of on and the sun to my attention. I noticed what is perhaps a connection between Helios, hello, and the sun, myself. From a basic and synchromystical point of view, I find it very plausible that on, hello, yes, are names for the glorious sun, which brings us so much joy. From an occult perspective, our consciousness perhaps is combined with our electric, in part, brains, and our brains are perhaps at one, so to speak, with the electric, in part, sun. The Vesica Pisces depicted within the sun in the St. Andrew's Cathedral emits an outflow of what is perhaps consciousness and transforming energies. The phallic obelisk on earth perhaps symbolically rises up to meet this vaginal Vesica Pisces in part. Such is the wonder of the esoteric understandings where the man has a bit of woman in him and the woman has a bit of man in her, so to speak. In this case, Mother Earth has the phalluses, whilst the male god has the vaginal Vesica Pisces. Although there are multiple aspects to this. Meanwhile, the thrice great female-male hermaphrodite Hermes looks on as part of this cosmic unified theatre. So within the sun we see the Vesica Pisces, which can be formed from the shape between two conjoined circles. These conjoined circles, in double form and even triple form and so on, perhaps represent time and space and the interconnection between them, electricity and magnetism. Now, as you can see on this Masonic illustration, mother and father, or mater and pater, matriarchal, patriarchal, mater, matter, pater, pattern, matter and pattern. Thus, the combination of matter and pattern, and perhaps time and space, electricity and magnetism, assist us to understand our surroundings and reality. There is no doubt more to it than this, should this in any way be correct. I will be showing some more observations along these lines in the video series, The Sydney Opera House Long Version videos. For now, I will show some more imagery, mainly from Optus. Just think about that glorious sun and enjoy. These days, for many, our celebrities are our priests, our ministers, min, moon, stir, star, moon and stars, ministers. So our celebrities, our celestial celebrities, are our stars. Here is celebrity pop star Kelly Rowland at the Optus Love Lounge in front of the Customs House Forecourt, Circular Quay, Sydney. Amidst the abundant symbolism, Rowland partakes in a creative process using Lego, whilst inside the Love Lounge. Indeed, our solar system's planets may have originated from the Sun. The Love Lounge's construction, particularly the hexagon, reminds me of beehives, as per the Queen Victoria Building, Sydney, the Masonic Centre, Sydney, and the New Zealand Parliament Building in Wellington. The beehive cluster of stars is situated within the Northern Hemisphere summer constellation of Cancer. Here you can see Cancer crabs at the base of an obelisk. The Yes Love Lounge, with its triangles and its hexagons, reminds me of the Disney Wonders of Life Pavilion, which housed the Cranium Command Show. As we can read from Optus, the Optus 180 project gives aspiring TV and filmmakers, directors, producers, and anyone who is keen to crack into the Aussie TV and film industry a shot at TV drama production. Perhaps I should submit an entry. Entrants are asked to submit a 180-second pilot for a chance to get their idea produced and aired on MTV, with a budget of $180,000. 180? Think of the Earth's yearly journey around the yes, the yes, the year, the year. In 2011, the 180 project winners, the heroes, got announced on Sunday, March the 20th, on cue with the equinox, equal day, equal night. In a similar fashion, Optus set up a cube tent beside Sydney's Museum of Contemporary Art, right next to Circular Quay. It opened on the 22nd of June, right on the solstice, the winter solstice for the Southern Hemisphere. Inside was a Hills Hoist-style clothesline with lemons dangling from it. Hills Hoist clotheslines rotate. Here is the Yes holding keys. Notice the Optus Yes on his hat is green, blue, turquoise, as is his tie. On this Masonic tracing board, the green woman represents the heart chakra, whilst the key hangs just below, perhaps in between the heart chakra and the solar plexus chakra. More on the symbology in the Sydney Opera House Long Version series. Optus supports Cirque du Soleil, Circus of the Sun. Circus, circuit. One can buy Cirque du Soleil sunrise tickets. Here is a female artist by the name of Jess. Check out her songs and lyrics sometime. This Yes was designed by artist Pinky. Check out his other works too. Optus Electrical is located in the heart of Brisbane, a company independent of Optus. Here is a few more Optus picks to enjoy whilst listening to music from artist Sean Walsh.
Can the Greek people in the audience tell me what these letters stand for? The word in our for affirmative in English is the name of the sun, and I'll prove it. Yes becomes yeah. becomes the year. And who is responsible for the year? There's the Pope with his yes.
I hope you enjoyed the video. I now find myself wondering as to the possible occult meanings behind words such as me, we, you, joy, and love. Please rate, comment, and subscribe. Goodbye. Hello!